What if a render job that would normally take multiple days of render time to finish could be done in a single afternoon? No joke, I'm about to show you the full workflow. We're starting again in 3dsMax with our Chaos Corona scene open. You might already know the first few steps, but they are crucial. Go into the render settings and switch the render engine to V-Ray GPU. After that, under the V-Ray tab, open the converters and start the V-Ray scene converter. Perfect. Now we'll export the entire scene to Vantage with a single click. Choose a location to save it, and a moment later, Chaos Vantage will open with your scene. Since we want to create an animation for social media this time, let's adjust the resolution. We'll set it to a vertical format, 1080 by 1920 pixels, perfect for Instagram Reels or TikToks. For a natural perspective without heavy distortion, I'll adjust the focal length to 40 millimeters and set the exposure mode to the simple value. Now, let's create the right atmosphere. For the environment, we'll once again use the physical sky in environment mode. This time, I'll increase the intensity to 2.25 for a bit more ambient light. The sky model will remain CIE overcast for that nice soft light. We'll activate the sun, but keep it very subtle, with an intensity of just 0.05. We'll set the position mode to altitude azimuth. Here, you can enter values that match your scene. For my scene, I'll choose 25 degrees altitude and 200 degrees azimuth. Lastly, we'll enable ambient occlusion for a bit more depth in the contact shadows. Very important. Create a new substate for these environment settings. This will allow us to easily reuse them later. Now for the lighting. We'll turn off all the artificial lights and then re-enable them, one by one. As I do this, I'll adjust the intensity of each light to perfectly match the new mood. For me, this usually means cutting the strength in half. Once everything looks right, we'll save this as a substate for the lighting as well. To bundle everything neatly, we'll now create a new main scene state that combines our environment and lighting substates. This is super handy if you want to use different lighting setups for different cameras later on. Okay, the scene is technically prepared. Now, let's give it that final cinematic look. In the Color Correction tab, we'll reduce the highlight burn to 0.12 to avoid losing detail in bright areas. Then, we'll activate the Filmic Tone Map. This helps us control a wider dynamic range. My values here are 0.2 for shoulder strength, 0.2 for linear angle, and 0.25 for toe strength. Feel free to play with these values until they fit your scene. For a gentle glow, we'll activate bloom with an intensity of 0.1. I'll again slightly reduce the hue saturation to minus 0.1. Finally, we'll set the white balance to 7000 Kelvin for a slightly warmer mood. And what do we do now? Exactly. Create a new substate for our color correction and update it in our main scene state. A clean workflow is everything. Now it's time to bring things into motion. For an animation, we obviously need a start point and an end point. We already have our start camera. Simply duplicate it. Now, let's navigate to the end position of our first camera movement. It's very intuitive. Hold down the right mouse button and move through the scene with the W, A, S, and D keys, almost like in a video game. Once you have your end position, open the video editor, and this is where the magic happens. Simply drag your start camera into the timeline, switch to shot mode, and then drag the end camera right after it. Chaos Vantage automatically creates a buttery smooth animation between the two points. To ensure the movement is steady, set the transition to linear. The most crucial part, however, is the duration. Pay attention to the move speed and adjust the time to create a smooth, consistent motion. Not too fast, not too slow. I want a nice shot of the sofa where not only the camera moves, but the sun does too. To do this, we'll create a new environment substate. And adjust the sun's position only for the endpoint. Then, we create a new scene state that uses this new sun position. Now, in the video editor, we apply this new scene state to the end camera. And voila, the sun now moves with the camera. How cool is that? Now it's all about telling the story. Create more camera paths, switch up the angles, the movements, and the focus objects. This adds variety and spice to your animation. Okay, final step, the render settings. We'll open the render setup and change the quality to ultra. We'll turn off the firefly filter, as it can sometimes cause small artifacts in animations. For more realistic light distribution, we'll set lighting GI to 4 bounces and reflective GI to full. The reflection and refraction bounces should be increased to 15. Double check your final resolution. We'll turn motion blur off. Make sure you are using at least 250 samples. A super important option is reduce flickering. Enable it to minimize any flickering spots in your animation. Save the frames as a PNG sequence in your desired location. Hit render and let the magic happen. Fantastic! The render is in progress. So, once the rendering process has finished, you'll find all your frames neatly saved as a PNG sequence in your folder. Now for the final assembly. Simply import that image sequence into a video editing program of your choice. For me, that's Adobe Premiere Pro. All you have to do then is make sure the timeline's frame rate is correct. And that's it. You've just created your first professional animation in Chaos Vantage. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If so, leave a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.